over, and Dan had started talking to him, and you know, and he had this hunger. I guess he was brought up in the church, but then sports took him away on Sundays, and he kind of just fell away from God. But he was hungry, and he saw that, and he wanted to. So we sat down and had an opportunity to better explain the gospel and to offer and ask him if he wanted that life. And we prayed, and he accepted the Lord in his heart. And he said, thank you so much. And he was excited, and I encouraged him to talk and share with his parents that are Christian. And his name is Kyle, I believe. Let's lift Kyle up in prayer.
Yes.
Thank you, Scott. Very close. we'll pray for Kyle, too. Lord, we thank you for your gift of salvation. We thank you, Lord, for using many in this body to reach out and to love. We know, Lord, that coming to invite you into our hearts is an amazing event where all the angels in heaven rejoice, but we also know it's just step one on this earth. Lord, you've called us to grow. You've called us to love, to be part of community, and to now do your work. And I ask, Lord, for strength for all of these people. We pray for Scott. We just lift him up. We thank you, Lord, for his obedience to your drawing. And we ask, Lord, that he would connect with his parents and other believers and just grow in his faith. We thank you for the privilege and opportunity to reach him. And Lord, we're just ordinary people in this little church here. And I thank you, God, for using us. We have so much disorganization sometimes, so many areas that we fall short. But Lord, you somehow manage to do big things. And we just, Lord, we want to continue to grow. So we worship you this morning. And we thank you that you are good. Even when circumstances are not great, you are good. We praise you because of who you are. In your name, Jesus.
Amen.
like this about faithfulness. That God actually desires our faithfulness and is actively moving towards our faithfulness. Not that he's waiting for us to be faithful, but that he wants our faithfulness even more than we do, and that he is acting towards that. The same thing with this song, like, your goodness is running after me, one of the bridge or whatever says, and basically that God cannot be not himself. So he is good, and his goodness is towards us because he wants us to be good. He wants that goodness to flow from us. So anytime we come to God and we want an aspect of God, he wants it more for us than we want it for ourselves. And he is actively working towards our victory in those areas, our growth, our sanctification, more than we are. Sometimes we think, we sit with God and we say, God, I just want to be more like this. And we think that we have to pray enough for God to give it to us. Well, he puts the desire in our hearts, and then he gives us the strength to move towards it and provides. He makes the way. He clears the path. He gives us what we need. He takes away the things that shouldn't be in our lives. He adds the things that should be in our lives. And we need to have that mindset that he is doing that. Because sometimes us thinking that we have to work for it and that, you know, we have to do enough for God for him to give it to us, sometimes that is the exact thing that is interfering with obtaining it. Because then we're actually not standing with God, who is saying, I want this for you more than you do, but we're standing and saying, God, I want this. Why aren't you wanting it as much as I do? Which is, it comes against, the mindset comes against, and we can actually interfere with God's ultimate desire for goodness, for our goodness, for our good. And so as we sing this, I want us to have that mindset that his goodness running after us. He is the one who's pursuing us, not us pursuing him. He is the one that wants our growth. He is the one who wants our strength. He is the one that wants us to be sanctified. He wants that for us more than we want it for ourselves. He died for us. We didn't die. We weren't good, and then he died. We were sinners. We were enemies, and he said, but I call you friends. He decided before we decided, and he continues to decide before we decide, and he continues to move in our lives more powerfully than we could ever imagine. He can do more than we can imagine, abundantly more than all we can think or imagine, and he's got good for us.
You are good. photo line.